Hi, this is Dr. Kay Sweetser from San Diego State University, and today I'm going to show you a quicker process that you can use to clean your data set when you download a file from Qualtrics. So here I have a study, and this is a really, really big study. This study has three different independent variables, and each of the independent variables has two to three different levels, so it's a pretty large factorial design, and we have 12 different cells in this particular data set. So the first thing that I want to do, of course, is go into Data and Analyze in Qualtrics, and then I want to export this file, so I'm going to export and import, export data, and I'm going to choose the SPSS download in here and download it. Now I've already downloaded this file and opened it up, and I want to show you a little bit about this file. So as I mentioned, we have 12 different cells, and I've previously made another video for you to show you how to create one variable that tells you which cell someone is in. Because as I look at the data set now, I see that I have these groupings where I have first click, last click, page submit, and click count, and then that repeats. Oops, it repeats first click, last click, page submit, da da da. And I have all of these for my 12 cells, but I have no one single variable that says this cell or this person was in cell number one, this person was in cell number two, etc. So also, as I look over my data set, I see I'm going to have a lot of cleaning to do because I personally just get annoyed at having all of this language in here. So here we have, you know, Q57 underscore 2. And there's all of this like lead up language, and I don't care about this lead up language. I really only care about this stuff at the end. And so I'd rather see a whole list of things like this in my variable label, as opposed to having all of this long text, because this will make my pivot tables in SPSS output really long if I keep this in here. So this really annoys me. So I could go through and I could manually do this. I could manually create a new cell variable. I've done that in a previous video for you. You can find it on my YouTube page. I could use syntax to create a cell variable, and I have a special video on that on my YouTube for you as well. And then I could also manually go through and do what I call clean the data, which when you do it manually can take about 2 to 3 or so hours. Now, because this has been such a large study with so many different cells, we really wanted to keep an eye on it throughout. And so we decided to use syntax for this particular experiment with regard to our data analysis so that we could quickly do the same procedure over and over to the brand new data set, the most recent data set, as more participants had participated in it. So I'm going to go ahead and open up my syntax file and show you how quickly we can clean the data here. So I'm going to go File, Open, and then I'm going to choose Syntax. And then I have a syntax file and a .sps file in here all ready to go. Now, my syntax file is pretty clean in here where I tell myself the things that I'm starting to do. So I have a section here where I'm actually defining that new variable for cell. And it's taking information from 12 different variables. And if a value in this variable is greater than 0, then it's going to create a new variable and give it the value of 1. If the value in this next different variable is greater than 0, then it's going to go into that newly created variable, and it's going to give it a value of 2. And this is how I create my quote cell variable, or my manipulation or treatment or stimulus variable, where I can tell in one single line of data which experimental cell or treatment the participant got. And then I give it a label, experimental cell, and then of course I give it the values. And so all of that would be akin to, let me make this a little bit smaller. So this would be the name. It would say cell over here. This would be where it says experimental cell. This is the label. And then the value would be 1 through 12 on my experimental cells there. So I go through and I also isolate. I've just done a couple of different things where I want to isolate my different independent variables in here. And then I wanted to clean up my variables, and I wanted to create some indices that have historically been made through the data. I'm also going to do that process where instead of manually going in and finding this extra information at the beginning, that it's basically the instructions that Qualtrics showed the participant on that item and deleting them out, I actually just wrote it in here to the syntax where it says variable labels for Q30. I want you to change it from, or I want you to change it to just say this. And so I've deleted out that front end stuff in here, and I have that on and on and on. I'm also going to, as a part of this, run my manipulation checks and then start to do some of my analysis in here. So this syntax file took me a couple of different sessions to do and to figure out what I wanted to put in here. I know that now that I've created this and I tend to use the same variables in my research, in the future it's going to be really easy for me just to pull it from here and then put it into a brand new syntax file. So with one data set only, please only have one data set open. You can see all I have in here is one single data set currently open on my computer. Do not have additional data sets open or versions of your file. With one data set open, come on over into your syntax file. You can either highlight only the stuff that you want to do, the procedure you want to do, like create a cell variable, and then press the green go button. And then it's going to open up an output file, an SPO file, and it's going to tell you what it did. And then you can go into your SAV file. And all the way at the bottom, I'm going to see a brand new variable there called cell. And sure enough, as expected, I have my 12 different cells in here. So I could do that one by one and pick the little things I want to do here and there and jump around my syntax file. Or if I'm really ready, I just highlight the whole thing and then press go. Now I want you to look at how we have all of this language up in here. These labels are really long. Those are going to change in a minute. I want you to look at right here where I'm asking about age. It's currently a Q42. That's going to change. Gender is currently got the name of Q43. That's going to change. Class level is going to change. And then I'm going to also add in a bunch more variables in here because that's just what I wanted to do with this particular syntax. So I have everything selected of all of the plans that I've made, so I can just get started and jump into my data analysis, and I'm going to press go. And again, my output file is going to pop up. I've asked it to do a couple of tests. I've asked it to do a lot of stuff in here, but that's not really what I want to show you right now. I want to jump back over here and I want to show you how now instead of the Q42, it says age. Instead of Q43, it says gender. Look at how much cleaner my data is here in the middle section where it no longer has those please refer to blah, 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 the instructions business. And so now my data set is pretty clean. And I can just go through and immediately start with my analysis. I have additional variables that I've created down here at the bottom, and I'm really ready to go. And this was a much faster process than the traditional type of cleaning that I showed you in another video. So have fun with syntax, and if you're ready to jump to the next level, this can really make your process go a lot easier, and you can Google everything to figure out what you're supposed to type in or how it is you're supposed to define this. So enjoy.